हेलो एंड नमस्कार एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द सेशन ऑफ पीआईबी 24/7। मैं हूं मनीष मिश्रा एंड गाइस, इन टुडे सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द इस्तांबुल कन्वेंशन एंड द ग्लोबल मैन्युफैक्चरिंग रिस्क इंडेक्स एंड आल्सो सम अदर इंपॉर्टेंट पीआईबी न्यूज। सो डू वॉच द कंप्लीट सेशन। तो चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं, बट बिफोर वी बिगिन देयर इज अ ह्यूज डिस्काउंट दैट वी आर ऑफरिंग ऑन द ओकेजन ऑफ रक्षाबंधन। अ ह्यूज डिस्काउंट ऑफ 30% वी आर गिविंग ऑन ऑल आवर कोर्सेज। सो यू हैव टू जस्ट use the code RAKHI30 to avail the 30% discount on all our courses. For more information, visit anujindal.in or call on this number. Right, so now let's begin with question number one. Poland is to withdraw from Istanbul Convention. What does Istanbul Convention aim at? So Poland jo hai Istanbul Convention se withdraw kar raha hai. Hume ye batana hai ki Istanbul Convention ka aim kya hai. Okay, so let us first guys discuss about the Istanbul Convention. So guys, it was adopted in the year 2011 by Council of Europe Committee of Ministers, and it is a convention on preventing and combating violence against women and domestic violence. महिलाओं के अगेंस्ट जो वायलेंस है और जो डोमेस्टिक वायलेंस है उसको प्रिवेंट करने के लिए, उसको खत्म करने के लिए इस कन्वेंशन को अपनाया गया था इन द ईयर 2011। एंड दिस कन्वेंशन इंक्लूड्स ऑल टाइप्स ऑफ वायलेंस, लाइक इट इंक्लूड्स रेप, इट इंक्लूड्स फिजिकल और मेंटल assault, it includes domestic violence, it includes forced marriage. Okay, so हर तरीके का violence जो भी एक महिला द्वारा face किया जाता है in our society, उन सभी को include किया गया है इस convention में, and it was adopted in the year 2011. And the very important thing about this convention is that it is the first legally binding instrument to prevent and tackle violence against the woman. ये दुनिया का पहला ऐसा legally binding instrument है, एक ऐसा कन्वेंशन है जिसके तहत वायलेंस जो है अगेंस्ट वुमेन उसको प्रिवेंट किया जाएगा और उसको टैकल किया जाएगा। और मार्च 2019 तक इसके अंदर 45 कंट्रीज थे और यूरोपियन यूनियन इसके सिग्नेटरीज थे। एंड रिमेंबर वन थिंग दैट इंडिया इज नॉट अ सिग्नेटरी ऑफ दिस कन्वेंशन, इंडिया इसका सिग्नेटरी नहीं है। नाउ लेट्स डिस्कस अबाउट द न्यूज कि पोलैंड जो है वो क्यों विड्रॉ कर रहा है फ्रॉम दिस कन्वेंशन। सो अकॉर्डिंग टू पोलैंड, दिस कन्वेंशन इज हार्मफुल बिकॉज इट रिक्वायर्ड स्कूल्स टू टीच चिल्ड्रन अबाउट जेंडर। मतलब ये कहना चाह रहा है ये पोलैंड का ये कहना है कि ये कन्वेंशन काफ़ी हार्मफुल है, बिकॉज ये इस कन्वेंशन के अकॉर्डिंग स्कूल्स को अपने चिल्ड्रन को ये सिखाना पड़ेगा, जेंडर के बारे में काफ़ी ज़्यादा नॉलेज देनी पड़ेगी, एंड दैट जेंडर इज ऑल्सो सोशो कल्चरली डिफाइंड, नॉट बायोलॉजिकली डिफाइंड। ओके, जो ये कन्वेंशन है इसके अंदर जो जेंडर है उसको डिफाइन किया गया है सोशो कल्चरली एंड नॉट बायोलॉजिकली। सो दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम विद पोलैंड। Okay, so this convention defines the term gender as socially constructed roles, behaviors, activities and attributes that a given society considers appropriate for women and men. And this is the problem with Poland. वो ये चाहता है कि जो gender है उसको biological terms में define किया जाए, ना ही social cultural terms में, right? और for example, अगर हम इसकी बात करें that some items of the convention foresee educating children and young people about forming होमोसेक्सुअल फैमिली। सो दीज आर सम प्रॉब्लम्स जो कि पोलैंड को है। पोलैंड का बेसिकली जो प्रॉब्लम है वो ये है कि जो जेंडर है उसकी डेफिनेशन को चेंज किया जाए, उसको बायोलॉजिकली डिफाइन किया जाए और ना ही उसको सोशो कल्चरल बेसिस पे डिफाइन करना चाहिए। ओके, सो दिस इज वाई पोलैंड इज विथड्रॉइंग फ्रॉम दिस इस्तांबुल कन्वेंशन। नाउ लेट्स मूव ऑन टू द क्वेश्चन। क्वेश्चन वॉज वॉट डज इस्तांबुल कन्वेंशन एम एट। सो गाइज, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दैट इट इज एम्ड एट preventing violence against women, preventing violence and all types of domestic violence against women, ye convention ka aim hai. Okay, now let's move on to question number 2, which is about the global manufacturing risk index, which has been released by Cushman and Wakefield. Guys, this is Cushman and Wakefield kya hai, ye basically ek real estate firm hai based in Chicago, right? Chicago based real estate firm hai ye. So we have to consider the following statement with respect to the India's position at this MRI and identify which statements are it incorrect. Okay, incorrect statements हमें identify करना है. So let us discuss about first the key features. So in total there were 48 countries that were selected from Europe, America and the Asia Pacific, and there were 20 variables that were classified under cost, competitiveness and operating condition. और इस index में basically होता यह है that this index puts the countries in 3 scenarios. That is baseline, cost and risk. इसको डिटेल में जानने की आपको कोई जरूरत नहीं है, बस आपको इतना पता होना चाहिए that this index puts countries in the 3 scenarios, that baseline, cost and risk. And according to this report, India is an upcoming manufacturing hub globally. India जो है global manufacturing hub बनने वाला है आने वाले समय में. And if you talk about the ranking, guys, so in the baseline scenario, number one is China, number two US, number three is India. In the cost scenario, number one China, number two Vietnam, number three India. And in the risk scenario, number one is Canada, number two US, and number three Singapore, while India's rank is what? 30th. Okay, now, so if we move on to the question, this is all about the index. Aapko itna hi padhna hai, isse zyada padhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai, itna more than enough hai. So if we talk about with respect to India's position, we have to find the incorrect statement. So India is on the third position for the baseline scenario. Yes, this is absolutely correct. India is on the third position for the risk scenario. No, for risk scenario, India is at 30th, while for cost scenario, India is at third position. All right. So jo statement 2 or statement 3 hai, dono hamare galat hai. So therefore, the correct answer should be what, guys? Option D, 2 and 3 are incorrect. Now, question number 3 is also based on this index. So the question is, the index puts countries in three scenarios. Which of the following is not one of them? Baseline scenario, cost scenario, risk scenario, all are the scenarios. So therefore, the correct answer will be what? Option D. All three are the scenarios. Now, question number 4 is about the guys app, which is named as BISCARE, B-I-S-CARE, which is launched by Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution, which is headed by Mr. Ram Vilas Paswan. And this mobile app, what is the objective of this app? The question is, what is the objective of this app? Guys, Bureau of Indian Standard is headquartered in New Delhi and it was established by BIS Act of 1986 and Mr. P.K. Tiwari is the chairperson of BIS. Okay, P.K. Tiwari is the chairperson. Now the question is, what is the objective of this app? So if you talk about this app, so guys, there are jo launch hua hai, wo ek to app hua hai, BISCARE and the three portals. So recently, Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution launched the BIS app that is named as BISCARE and three portals, which are the standardization, conformity assessment and training portals. These are the three portals that has been launched by the Ministry of Consumer Affairs, Food and Public Distribution for the betterment of consumers. Okay, consumers ki bhalai ke liye in teen portals ko launch kiya gaya hai. And if we talk about the app, guys, so the app is operational in both the Hindi and English language. And through this app, consumers can check the authenticity of ISI marked and hallmarked products. And also they can lodge complaint using this app against any fake ISI marked or hallmarked products. Right? Agar jo consumer hai, wo isme ISI mark ki aur ki authenticity check kar sakte hai, hallmarked product ki authenticity check kar sakte hai. And also they can lodge complaints against any defaulter. Okay. So therefore, guys, the correct answer should be what? Option A. For checking the authenticity of ISI and hallmark quality certified products. Okay, so therefore option A is the correct answer. Now let's move on to question number 5, which is the last question for today. For faster execution of Chardham project in Uttarakhand, Union Environment Ministry has approved the zonal master plan for the eco-sensitive zone. Now can you tell me the meaning of eco-sensitive zone? So let me tell you its meaning. So guys, basically eco sensitive zone are the fragile areas within 10 kilometers of the protected areas. Protected areas ke 10 kilometer ke andar ka fragile ecosystem jo hota hai, usko hum bolte hain ecosystem, eco sensitive zone. Aur ye protected area ho sakta hai, national park ho sakta hai, ya fir wildlife sanctuary bhi ho sakta hai. And the basic aim behind these eco sensitive zone is to regulate certain activities, that can cause harm to this fragile ecosystem. Okay, ये जो eco-sensitive zone है, इसका जो basic aim है, is to regulate certain activities जो कि इस fragile ecosystem को नुकसान पहुंचा सकते हैं. And these eco-sensitive zones are notified by Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change under the Government of India. Okay, and now the question is, Union Environment Ministry has approved the zonal master plan for which eco-sensitive zone? Kaun se eco-sensitive zone ke liye ek zonal master plan approved kiya gaya hai? So recently, guys, Union Environment Ministry has approved the ZNP for Bhagirathi eco-sensitive zone for faster execution of Chardham project. And this Chardham project proposes to connect Yamunetri, Gangotri, Badrinath and Kedarnath, which are the places of Chardham Yatra in Uttarakhand. And it will bear the cost of rupees 12,000 crore. Jo total cost hai iske andar wo kitni aayegi? 12,000 crore rupee aayegi. And guys, this Bhagirathi eco-sensitive zone was first notified by the Environment Ministry in the year 2012. Basically, ab aapko is slide mein se do important cheeze hai, wo yaad rakhni hai. Ek to ye कि भगीरथी इको सेंसिटिव जोन के लिए फास्टर एग्जीक्यूशन चार धाम प्रोजेक्ट के लिए जोनल मास्टर प्लान प्रपोज किया गया है, अप्रूव किया गया है। एंड अदर देन दिस, जो चार धाम यात्रा होती है उसके अंदर कौन से चार प्लेसेस होते हैं? यमुनोत्री, गंगोत्री, बद्रीनाथ एंड केदारनाथ। ओके, सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट गाइस? ऑप्शन ई, भगीरथी इको सेंसिटिव जोन। ऑलराइट, भगीरथी इको सेंसिटिव जोन इज द करेक्ट आंसर। ओके गाइस, सो दैट्स इट फॉर द सेशन टुडे। आई होप यू लाइक इट। फॉर मोर अपडेट्स डू सब्सक्राइब आवर चैनल एंड प्रेस द बेल आइकन। आपको ये सेशन कैसा लगा प्लीज कमेंट करके जरूर बताएं। गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस।